Breaking tonight, a live look at Ferguson, Missouri, where just about 24 hours ago, the city exploded after the grand jury decision came down to not indict police officer Darren Wilson in connection with the death of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Tonight, new charges that the U.S. legal system is tainted, broken, and racist.
All across America, President Means, whether it's in New York, Los Angeles, California, Cleveland, young people of color being killed by police officers, I've never seen a prosecutor hold a press conference to discredit the victim.
It feels like we've given license that when a person is intimidated by a black person in this country, you can pull out your gun and shoot them, and that's very disconcerting.
This is St. Louis's race war. We didn't have a race war like other cities throughout the country. This is our race war. I know of people in my own party, in my own government structure, who disregard things that we say and how we feel, and we are not going to allow it anymore.
This is a problem throughout the country where you have law enforcement officers that are afraid and fearful of young black men, and they're pulling out their guns and shooting them down and killing them each and every day.
Joining me now, Vincent Warren. He just returned from Ferguson. He's executive director of the Center for Constitutional Rights and a former attorney for the ACLU. Also, Jason Riley, who's a Wall Street Journal editorial board member and a Fox News contributor. Thank you both for being here. Jason, let me start with you to get reaction from that. This is our race war, and police officers just have a fear of black men that makes them want to pull out their guns and shoot them.
Yeah, the left is selling a false narrative here. We have too many black dead bodies in this country, but cops are not the reason. The black homicide rate is much too high. It is the leading cause of death for young black men. But blacks also commit 7 to 10 times more violent crime in this country than whites do. And 90% of their victims are other black people. We have so many dead black bodies in this country, Megan, not because cops are shooting them, but because other black people are shooting them. And the left is selling a false narrative out there, pretending that the opposite is true.
What of these claims juxtaposed against what we heard last night from the prosecutor, what we've seen now that was presented to the grand jury, African-American witnesses going in there and saying, I'm telling you, it is exactly as the officer said it was. Michael Brown charged him. He shot, he stopped, he waited. Michael Brown charged again, he shot again. That's from African-American witnesses. How can this be a race war?
Well, I'm not calling it a race war, and I also disagree with the idea that the primary problem with dead black men are other black people. But, you know, with respect to your question, here's the issue. It's not the race of the witnesses that matter. It's the race of the victim and the race of the perpetrator. And this is a situation here in Ferguson where those things are clear. It was a white police officer that killed a black man. I'm not saying that he killed him because he was black, but I am saying that black folks now that have to deal with all of these people that are killed by the police officer, whether or not they have a gun, that is a tremendous problem. That has to be resolved in this country, and it doesn't matter what the race of the
victim. It was a legal matter. Whether or not he actually had a gun is almost irrelevant. What matters is what the officer had reason to believe.
Well, you know, Megan, as a legal matter, it actually does matter whether the person had a gun or not. And I'll tell you why.
It's what's in the officer's head.
It's true. But if the officer was saying, you know what, I have an unusual fear of black people and didn't say that,
correct,
didn't confess
right.
that, and said, but I feared for my life, most people might say it's perfectly fine for him to do it. It does actually matter because we use our senses. We use what we see. The man was unarmed when a police officer killed an unarmed black person.
But the cop didn't know that. And let's keep in mind that this confrontation occurred because Michael Brown took a shot at a cop who was sitting in his cop car and reached for his gun.
The issue here is black criminality, not the behavior of cops. It's the behavior of these young black men in these communities. Whenever a Ferguson goes down, we start talking about racial profiling. We start talking about poverty. We start talking about unemployment. We start talking about tensions between the cops and black people. Those are effects. Those are not causes. The cause here is black criminality. The fact that blacks who are 13% of the population are responsible for an outsized amount of violent crime in this country.
Jason,
until that ends,
let me give you another
fact. Going to have racial profiling.
The question
you are
is
going
actually
to have
not
between blacks,
black criminality.
Black community and police.
The question is
Go
not
ahead,
black
Vincent.
Criminality. The question is the criminalization of black people. Here's the point. all black people do not commit crimes. Therefore, all black people should not be policed in communities just because they're black.
This is not about
police
departments.
When police departments occupy black communities, when police departments occupy black communities,
but where's the responsibility for what Michael Brown did? Where is the responsibility? He committed a crime that night. That's clear.
Here's the question. That's not the question, Megan. The question is, where is the responsibility for what Officer Wilson did?
No, but you're jumping over. You're treating Michael Brown like he was a squeaky clean kid. Minding his own business.
I'm treating Michael
Brown. He had just committed a robbery.
Like he's a human
being. The witness testimony is that he attacked a police officer.
We're all aware of what
the testimony
is. Here's the question. I'm treating Michael Brown like he's a human being. Michael Brown was not the subject of that grand jury proceeding, although you would think he was, because we heard more about what Michael Brown did from the testimony than we did about what Officer Wilson did.
Because if you attack a cop and charge after him, it's relevant to whether that cop has a right to defend himself.
When the information is coming out from the grand jury, we're looking at it all. One of the things that I saw when I looked at it was that the sergeant went to talk to Officer Wilson right after Michael Brown was shot. Michael Brown is dead on the ground, and the sergeant did not take down, write down, or record the statement of the police officer. Not only is that bad policing, it also sends the message that, my goodness, how can we be surprised that Darren Wilson's testimony fits the evidence when they didn't record Darren Wilson's testimony at the event?
Did that sergeant also speak with all the African-American witnesses who came forward?
It's not about the police. It is not about the over-policing of black communities and young black men getting picked on by cops. Blacks are arrested at the same rate that victims of crimes identify blacks as their assailants. This is not about cops are in these communities because that is where the 9/11 calls originate. And they are largely there stopping blacks from harming one another.
Well,
this is not about the cops.
If your answer is that people that live in black communities that haven't done anything wrong just have to live with the fact that they will get shot by police officers, I would say to you,
would Michael Brown have been shot by Darren Wilson if he hadn't broken the law that day?
Who can answer that question? Police officers will shoot people whether they've broken the law or whether they haven't.
Then why don't those cases get put in? Those are the cases, the clear cases, that should be shoved in people's faces front and center on the news, and people should be forced to discuss it. Why take a case like this, which is so conflicted, in which there are so many African-American witnesses supporting the story of the white cop, where it's much more difficult for us to come together as a nation
I'll
and say,
that.
Go ahead, quickly.
Because the left wants to use racism as an all-purpose explanation for what ails the black community. Certain situations fit that narrative, like Ferguson. Certain situations do not, like Chicago.
All right, guys, good debate. Thank you both for being here. Coming up, he's covered wars and conflicts around the globe, but he says he has never seen anything like he saw last night. Live report from Steve Harrigan on the ground tonight in Ferguson.